Jeez, I wonder if I even still know how to do this. Let's see. Let's screw this on here. This is, I haven't done one of these in fucking forever, man. There we go. Let's see. Turn the light on. Get this shit ready. There we are. I think we're ready to go. Hey, what's going on, everyone? Long time no see, right? Welcome to a new video. It's been quite a long time since I've made one. Quite a long time since you've heard this sexy voice on your through your speakers or headphones, right? Yeah, it's been quite a long time since I made my last video. That was July of 2018 is when I uploaded the last time I made a video. And I believe that video was actually recorded back in June of that year. So, yeah, it was my 2018 Q&A, and I took a bit of a while uploading that. So it's been a long time. Basically, yeah, if you're wondering, oh, is Jack dead? Did he finally kill himself? No, I've actually been doing quite the opposite. I've been actually trying to focus on a lot of stuff in my life and been trying to focus on, my work, my social life outside of, you know, YouTube and all that. I've been just trying to make myself into a better person. And the time while I did that, the last year or so, I've just kind of neglected YouTube. And lately, the last few months, I'd say, last 6 months or so, I've been wanting to get back into YouTube. I did make a status on my YouTube channel's Facebook page about wanting to come back, but I think I made that on Christmas, just to give you guys a bit of an update as to what's going on there. But yeah, overall, I've just been trying to focus on my own life. So I'm not going to let that distract too much from what today's video is about. If you do want a video going into detail, not too much detail, but like going into why I've been absent for the last year, let me know down in the comments. But I don't want to distract from today's video. But let's just say today's video is not going to be like the last video for a while. Like I'm going to be getting back into this. So today's video is about something that I have actually just recently purchased just this past weekend. Actually, I went out out shopping with a friend, and I decided to go on a bit of an impulse buy, as I usually do. Now, with my new job, I've been able to save up quite a bit of money, and, I can afford to just buy expensive shit now, and, not that I'm rolling in it, like, I've still got this, I still wear the same, you know, shitty clothes and all that sort of stuff, you know, all the time, but, like, it's, I've got a bit of disposable income, and I figured, I've wanted one of these for a while, so I figured, why not buy it? So, today's video is going to be about something video game related, something that's related to video games, Nintendo specifically, and it's a console. So I bought a Nintendo Switch.
It's this game my father taught me years ago. It's called Switch. The premise of the game is you take one finger, put it in your mouth, the other one goes up your asshole. When he says go, you switch.
Now, I've been wanting a Switch for quite a while, actually. I've actually been wanting one since it came out. Really, that was back in 2017 is when the Switch came out. And I've been wanting one ever since, actually. Once a couple games I liked actually came out for it. So, as you guys know, I actually did used to have a Wii U. And I had that Wii U for a couple years, and I liked it, but it just didn't have enough games to really keep me interested in it. I remember I got the Wii U back in, I think, 2014, I think, about 5 years ago, I think. I bought the Wii U, and I got it with, I originally got Mario Kart 8. That's the reason I bought the Wii U, was Mario Kart 8, and then I got Super Mario 3D World, and then I had a few other games too as well. I ended up buying a lot more of the exclusives, or really, that's really all that was on their console, was just Nintendo stuff, basically. And so I remember when I first got it, I played a shit ton of Mario Kart 8, I played a shit ton of Mario 3D World, and then it kind of sat for a while. I remember picking up another game. I think it was when Mario Maker came out, I picked that up and played a little bit of that. And then it sat again for like a while. And I remember it would literally be collecting dust with my consoles. And then eventually I just took it out of my console setup, my gaming setup overall. And then eventually I traded it in. I got rid of it. I traded it in at EB Games with all my accessories, because I actually bought a lot of accessories for the Wii U as well. I bought a pro controller. I bought an Ethernet adapter. I bought a Wii. I specifically bought another Wii remote and nunchuck for it in the correct matching color, because I had a black one, so I had the black remotes as well. I had everything for it. I had the 32 gig deluxe Wii U, and so I had all the accessories. And so I traded that in, as well as like about there was about 10 or so games, or some original Wii games were in that list too. Back in January of 2018, because I wasn't using the thing, and I was gonna save up for a Switch. Now at the time, I didn't have a job yet, so I was still unemployed at that time, so I didn't really have the money to buy the Switch. So what I did is I got store credit when I traded in the Wii U and all my accessories and games. So I got $275 with the store credit, and it was on a gift card. That sat in my wallet until just yesterday, actually. I wanted to keep that on there just so I could, buy the Switch, because the Switches are expensive, and I was waiting for the price to sort of drop down a bit. They never did. So the Switches have always, sort of been, this one was advertised for $465 with two games bundled. And so not the two games I actually did buy with it. But I got two other games, and so what I actually they wouldn't negotiate down to have the Switch without those two games, so I've got them. There are a couple of download codes. I'll just chuck them up on eBay because they're games I don't really care about. One's Fortnite and one's fucking some cricket thing, I don't fucking know. But it was the same price to buy the Switch in that bundle as it would be by itself, so I figured, you know what, why not get it with the two games? I can just chuck them up on eBay and fucking get rid of them that way. So what I did, I also bought a Switch Pro controller as well, because I'm mostly going to be using this thing docked, and so we'll get to that in a minute, as well as I got two other games. So the two games I actually care about, Mario Kart 8 Deluxe. So this is a Wii U title that has been remastered and put on, I wouldn't say remastered, but ported over to the Switch, and Deluxe means it has all the DLC, I think. From Mario Kart 8, which I actually ended up buying for the Wii U. I really love this game so much, I actually went out and bought a DLC for it back on the Wii U. So yeah, that's how much I love Mario Kart 8. But the Wii U never kept me interested enough to just keep playing it, so, but now I've got it again. As well as I also bought Super Mario Odyssey, because I'm a bit of a sucker for the 3D Mario games. I loved Mario 64. I never played Sunshine, but I do want to at some point. And then I loved Mario Galaxy 1 and 2. Those were some of the best games I've ever played, to be honest with you. And Super Mario 3D World on the Wii U was actually really good as well, even though it was sort of a 2D, 3D hybrid. So I'm really excited to play this one as well. So this is going to be good. This is going to be cool. And I'm really going to be excited to get back into Mario Kart, because I love Mario Kart Online. That's why I played, is the online with others. I mean, it's also a good party game as well. But yeah, Mario Kart 8 Online was pretty dope. So enough rambling. What I'm going to do is I'm actually going to open this up now. So let me open it up here. It wasn't sealed, so I actually have not opened the box yet. I've had this sitting in my room for about a day. I have not opened up the box. So here you can see a Switch. I got the grey one. So as you can see, I've got the grey one. I do apologize about the kind of terrible lighting here. I did get the grey the grey Joy-Cons. I didn't want the coloured ones. I think they look kind of tacky, to be honest. I kind of like minimalist. Like, everything that I have, is kind of black or grey. So there we are. So you can see there's the Joy-Cons. They come off. You've all seen a Switch before, I'd imagine. So this is the type of mode around the box. You can see there's the type of mode you can use it in. So you got handheld. You can use the Joy-Cons on their own. You can have it like standing up like that with a little flimsy stand, which we'll get to. You can see, and you can put the Joy-Cons on the grip there and use it with your TV and slide them on and off the Switch there. And the other side's the same. Oh, not quite, but it just shows the different modes. You can see putting it in the dark and whatnot. So there we go. So that's just enough of the box. So let me just go ahead and open this up for you guys. So it opens up this way. Like I said, it's been sitting in my room for about a day. I haven't opened it yet, because I wanted to do this on video. And me having, I've got a bit of anxiety. I wanted to get back into YouTube, but I kind of kept procrastinating. So yeah, that's why this thing's been sitting. I've wanted to touch this thing, but I haven't been able to. And we are here. We are presented with the Switch. Okay, so first of all, I'll take out the Joy-Cons. We'll get to the Switch in just a sec. So there we are. Here are the Joy-Cons. So they're actually heavier than I thought they were. Now a couple of friends of mine do have Switches. A couple of my friends at work do have Switches. I know one of them she has a Pokemon themed one that has bright yellow Joy-Cons because she's a bit of a Pokemon nerd. And I do have another friend who has another Switch, and her and her partner, they have the color Joy-Cons. So here is the Switch itself, and wow, that is. Yeah. Now, I have held one of these, but not brand new out of the box. And it weighs more than I thought. It weighs more than I remember it feeling last time, because I felt it with the Joy-Cons on there. It felt kind of light, but without the Joy-Cons, it's kind of... It's got a bit of, it's kind of dense, actually, to be honest. It looks... Here is, you know, an iPhone comparison, you know, compared to my iPhone 10, so there you go. So it is similarly sized to an iPhone, a little bit bigger. It's kind of, it looks kind of like an Nexus 7, actually, in terms of size. I reckon it's about that big, maybe a little bit smaller, I'm not sure. If you remember that old Nexus 7 tablet from, like, 2013. Anyway, so I'm just going to get rid of that cardboard. What else do we have in here? I've actually never watched an unboxing of one of these before, so I've actually got no idea what it comes with. What's this? HDMI cable? Yep, cool. HDMI. So it just looks like a standard HDMI cable. I won't take that out of the bag. I mean, I'll use it. It comes with a power cord, and it is USB Type-C, which is excellent. I love USB Type-C. I wish my iPhone used it, but it uses Lightning. USB Type-C is awesome, and I love that. And there we go. So there we are, and it's got the Australian plug on it, so... There we go. What else do we have in here? So this looks like... these are the Joy-Con grip things. Yeah, so what you can do, I think, with these... so you slide on the... is that what this is? I think so. Yes, it is. Is there another one? There should be two of these. So what you can do is... unless the one's already on one of the Joy-Cons, I don't think so. So you slide this onto the Joy-Con. So you can protect the little side connectors here, even though you don't need to do that. You can do it anyway. It's a bit, and it has like a little strap on it as well, like a like a little hand strap you can put around your wrist. So there it is. Yeah, I think so. It slides onto the side of the Joy-Con there. It's honestly, I really don't know why this is necessary. They could have just designed it in a way where you didn't need something stupid as this, but whatever. Then again, the Nintendo could have designed the Switch in a lot of ways, which is kind of silly. What do we have here? There's only one of them, unless I'm missing... Oh, no, here's the other one. Yeah, so here's the other one. I didn't see that. From the angle I'm sitting at, I can't really see much of the box. Here is the Joy-Con grip. So what this is for is... so you can actually grab the... where's the fucking... There it is. So you grab the Joy-Con, and you can take them off the Switch and use them with this. This is stupid. I don't recommend using this. If you're going to use it docked, get a Pro Controller, which we'll get to in just a minute, which is what I've done. So, I have the Pro Controller. I don't plan on using this at all, so this can actually stay in the box. The Joy-Cons themselves, I'll just keep on the Switch. I'm not going to ever use the Joy-Con grip. I think it's honestly stupid. I really don't like the idea of it. I mean, the idea of it's cool, but as a second controller, it's fine, but the Joy-Con doesn't make a good enough normal controller, and we'll get to that in a minute, so... we have some warranty info here, and this looks like the dock for the Switch is in this bubble wrap here. So let me just move this box out of the way. And sorry, I'm keeping a tripod there. My apologies. All right, so here we take one condom off, and we take the other condom off. There we go. And here's this is smaller than I thought. Okay. there we are. Here is the dock for the Switch. It is. Actually, kind of cheap feeling, to be honest with you. So we have two USB Type-A ports on the side. So I'm hoping you can plug in like USB flash drives or external hard drives or something to extend the storage. Because the Switch, unfortunately, only has 32 gigs of storage built in. Now, I know you can put an SD card in, and I didn't buy an SD card for one of these. I wanted to, but EB were out of stock at the time. Now, I know I can get them elsewhere. I should mention that I did use my $275 gift card for my store credit for my Wii U on my Switch. So I ended up saving a bunch of money on this stuff, so which is cool. Yeah, but I'm hoping that I will get an SD card at some point. I think I have an old 32GB SD card in one of my old phones somewhere, so I might be able to stick that in temporarily until I buy a bigger one. But for the time being, I've only got two games. For now, and I think having the 32GB SD card and the 32 built into the Switch will be fine for now. I'll get a bigger card eventually. So in the dock here, you can see, I don't know how well you can see that, you can see there's a USB Type-C port in there, which is what the Switch docks into, which we'll get to in a minute. And I believe this comes off. How does this back piece come off here? Because I believe that, oh, there we go, it just unhinges. You can see there is the, I think that's where you plug in your power, You have the HDMI, and you have your USB 3.0 port. So I'm really, because this has USB 3.0, I'm really hoping you can plug in an external hard drive into there. That would be rad. And you just, like, you know, get like a 1 terabyte drive or something, or a 2 terabyte, and just, you know, plug that in. And because most people, I guarantee you, use these things docked. I don't know if Nintendo release stats numbers for actually how people use them, but I guarantee people just use these things docked anyway, most of the time, like 90% of the time. So just, you know, just let us have like an external hard drive if you can. I don't know if you can or not. I'm hoping you can, because the 32 gigs of space is pretty anemic, if you ask me. So that's the dock. I'll move that out of the way. The accessories, I'll move that out of the way. I'll grab the Switch and the Joy-Con so we can have a look at those. Actually, before we do that, I'm going to have a look at the Pro Controller. So, we'll open this up. So, the Pro Controller. So, I bought this. I like dedicated controllers. I'm a huge fan of the Xbox One controller, and I have an Elite controller for that as well. So I really like the shape of that. I liked the old Wii U Pro controller. I really liked that. They had a couple of problems though. I didn't like the Wii U Pro controller, how it had, the two analog sticks were symmetrical, but they were up. So let me grab my Xbox One controller and I can show you. So here's my Xbox One Elite controller. So I really love the shape of this. So what the issue with the Wii U Pro controller was, is it was a similar shape to this, the Xbox 360 controller actually, which was nice, which is similar to this. But the thing is, instead of the thumbsticks being not symmetrical, they're symmetrical, which isn't an issue, but they're all above here, and so your face buttons and your D-pad were down here, and I didn't really like that much. I like having the opposite thumbsticks like that, because I like having the face buttons and the analog stick up here. Depending on what game I'm playing, if I'm playing a platformer, obviously the D-pad will be better, but the Xbox One's D-pad's not... Yeah, it's pretty good actually, so at least on the Elite controller anyway. That was the problem with the Wii U's Pro controllers, but I can see that they've solved that with the Switch one. You can see the sticks are not symmetrical, and they're in the proper places, and it has a real D-pad, which if you have a look at the Joy-Cons later on, you'll see that it doesn't have one. So, let me open this up. I wonder if this uses USB Type-C as well. I actually have no idea. So there is some instructions and paperwork. We don't need to look at that. We have the box. We have a USB cable. Now this is... What type of USB cable is it? So it's got type A on one end. And what type is it on the other end? But I hope... If it's micro B, I am going to not be happy. Oh no, it's type C. Alright, that is cool. So type A to type C cable. Nice. Cool. And so I can use that to charge a controller. I'm glad it's Type-C. I'm glad we are moving towards a Type-C Thunderbolt 3 future. Obviously it's not Thunderbolt 3, but I like the fact that we have these, a lot of machines now, a lot of computers and stuff have the universal, Type-C, so it's like a universal plug pretty much, and that's awesome. I think we're really just waiting on Apple to update the fucking iPhone to get that. You know, here's the Switch Pro Controller, and So it's not as heavy as my Xbox Elite, but it's decent. So this feels really good, actually. Except the lack of analog... So one thing I would like to have is analog... So I've heard that these are digital triggers, and yeah, they're digital buttons, the triggers on the back. If those were analog... This would probably be a good controller. I mean, a really good controller. D-pad feels... Yep, so let me just rotate that a bit. So D-pad feels good, actually. Yeah, so D-pad feels good, but it sticks. So I click in. Yep, sticks feel great. Nice, they feel nice and precise. Start, stop button, a few other buttons here. It looks like there's a home button. I'm not sure what that one is. What about the face buttons? Yeah, those are alright. They're a bit... they're a bit mushy. Let me grab my Xbox controller so I can compare. Cause these are, like, this is my standard for everything. Is the Elite controller. So they've got a different... They're a different feel. So they're nice and clicky, which is alright. They're not as clicky as my Xbox's controller, though, like buttons. But I like how they're a matte finish. The Xbox buttons, they're glossy. These, after playing like an hour, like hours of Red Dead or whatever, these can get like kind of, you know, gummy and kind of disgusting, even on the Elite controller, which has got this nice soft touch. The buttons themselves get kind of gummy and disgusting after a while if you're a disgusting slob like me. So, bottom here, I wonder what that means. I think that's probably just to show you what controller number you are. I wonder if the battery life on this is any good, like the old Wii U Pro controller was, where it was like 80 hours or something ridiculous. Some plastic on there, we won't take that off just now. Yeah, there we go. Actually, what I will do is I will do this for you guys. That is always satisfying every time you do that. Yeah, baby. Okay, someone just stick that stuff in there. Yeah, but that is, and it has a Type-C port, which is nice. Although, glossy plastic. Fuck you, Nintendo. Fucking glossy plastic. But, you know, it's on the back of the controller, so it's the least of my worries. But overall, it looks like a nice controller. So, let me clear out some of this stuff out of the way, and we can go ahead and have a look at the actual Switch itself. Okay, let's actually have a look at the Switch itself now. So, let me go ahead and take it out of the plastic. There we go. And yeah, it looks actually pretty cool. I like the soft, the plastic back. So here is the little stand. How's this come out? Wow, that is, yeah, and people weren't lying. That is really flimsy. Like, look at that. It's just, oh my god, Nintendo. Why couldn't you design something like, this is what, I remember when the Switch came out. This is, like, and this is what I was comparing it to. This is what they should have designed for the Switch. This is an original Surface Pro. They should have designed the hinge to be like this. This is really sturdy. It's a little bit wobbly, but, like, look how sturdy this hinge is, like, for the stand. Look how flimsy this little stand is. Like, this is terrible. So you can't see that. Look at that. It's, like, it's really flimsy. Whereas, you know, they should have designed it a little bit. So it's like that. And this is like a 6-year-old tablet at this point. Like, modern Surface Pros have, you know, better stands on them. But, you know. Yeah, that's, that is a horrible stand there. But, I mean, I guess if you wanted to put it in, grab, like, there we go. That's, you know, that's not even going to sit on my bed, right? But, yeah, there we go. I guess on a hard surface, it'll be alright. So on the bottom here, you can see, there's the USB Type-C port. What else is that surrounding it? Oh, those are the, I think, the magnets that align. Also, like, the little posts that align it in the dock there. So there's the Type-C port. That's where the Joy-Cons go. You can see here, I think, is the game slot there. Yep, so that's where you put your games. And how's that shot? It's a bit of a little flimsy there. What is that? Is that a headphone jack? I think that's the headphone jack. There's the cooling vent. There's a power. No, is that power? Is that. No, it's volume up and down, and I think that's a power button. I think that's a power button. Yeah, it is. Yes, that's the power button, your volume up and down, your vent. See where the other Joy-Con goes. In the back here, you can see if I open up the little stand, that's where the slot for the micro SD card goes. So, yeah, I'm going to be sticking in a 32. I think I have a 32 gig card on an old Android phone that I have. So, my old Sony Xperia, which I haven't really been using, so, yeah, I'll take the card out of that. We'll take the Joy-Cons out of their little plastic sleeves, little plastic, you know, packaging here. So, these are alright. See, but the thing is, the problem with them, and the reason why I got the Pro Controller, is that there's no D-pad. So, you have these directional buttons, but it's not a D-pad. Like, it's, yeah, because the reason they did this, instead of giving you a real D-pad, is they wanted these to come off so that you can, you know, use it as, like, a little mini-controller. And so if you have, like, you know, you could have multiplayer people and you could have, like, these two little mini-controllers on them. To be honest, I am never going to use that functionality ever, so these Joy-Cons are going to stay on here and probably never come off, because what I'll do is when I dock it, I'll just use my Pro Controller. When I take it portably, I'll just use these. So, and these just slide on here, just like that. There we go, and it's kind of wide. There we are. So, I'll get my iPhone again. You can see the comparison, you know, how big it is with an iPhone 10. So, you know, there's an iPhone 10. Let me unlock it so you can see the screen. There we go. So there we are. You can see, you know, compared to an iPhone 10, you know, There we are. The screen itself is about the size of an iPhone X. So there we go. So yeah, that's not bad actually. And I think if you want to get these off, you let's see. So on the Joy-Cons and stuff, you have the A, B, X, Y. You have the plus and minus buttons at the top. You have your thumbsticks, which these thumbsticks actually feel pretty nice. They're not as nice as the Pro Controller ones. They're smaller. They kind of feel like the PS Vita thumbsticks, actually. In terms of the way they feel like the PS Vita thumbsticks. Like, they're kind of small. Now, I never owned a Vita, but I have played one before, and it was actually pretty cool. Yeah, so these come off with little buttons on the back. So, there we are. It just slides off like that. And then you can get, you know, either different colored ones or whatever, you can swap them out. I just wanted the gray, because I like just minimalist, you know, just basic design. I don't really want anything fancy. So I don't really like bright colors with my electronics, to be honest. So if you've seen my stuff before, you've seen I just usually go for black everything if I can. So there we are, one and two. There we go. There we go. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go ahead and make room for this on my my console setup, and get the dock set up, and let's just go through the setup experience, and maybe play a little bit of a game or two if we can, if we have time. So here is my current main setup. So it's been a while since I don't think I've ever really showed it recently. Well, I mean, of course I haven't made a video recently, but it's been like this for the past year or so. Just got my main desktop here, got Xbox One, PlayStation 4, 360, PlayStation 3, and now I've made room for the little Nintendo Switch there. So there we go. I'm just going to go ahead and plop the Switch into the dock. I've got it sitting right there, and we're going to go ahead and set it up. I've got the TV on the right input, and let's see what it does. Alright, let's go ahead and pop the little Switch into the dock here. So let me just go ahead and slide her in. Yeah, just like that, baby. Oh, lit up. Alright, there we go. Looks like it's charging. And there's a little green light flashing on the actual dock itself. Let's see what's happening. It is saying to take the Switch out of the dock. Okay, so I literally just set up my tripod for no reason, eh? If I can't set it up on the TV. Classic Nintendo. Alright. Let's reposition the camera. Alright, I'm going to take the Switch out of the dock now. So, let's see what happens when I pull it up. Okay, let's see. Ah, it's like my language. Okay, let's see if we can reposition the camera here just a bit. There we go. Okay, and I never said I'd be more professional when I came back, guys. Alright. Let's see, English, okay, what's my region, I am in Australia, okay, please read important, blah 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 blah, sorry I'm not showing you guys, I'll just reposition that a bit, it's hard for me to see, that's all, let's see, important information, let's see, how can I just go back, okay, next. I like the feeling of the controls. This actually feels kind of I kind of like the shape of this, actually, holding the Switch like that. Because the bottoms here, like, sort of go into your palms. Alright, select the Wi-Fi network. Alright, is this a touchscreen as well? I think it is. It is. Yeah. Let me go ahead and put on my Wi-Fi. Of course, Nintendo does these cutesy little sounds. What? I might have typed my password wrong. My Wi-Fi network sometimes has problems. There we go. Alright. Let's continue. Let's see. I'm not in Sydney, but I am in Melbourne. So, yes, Melbourne. You can use your Nintendo Switch on its larger screen by connecting to a TV. Yes, let me go connect to a TV, please. So don't have to look at this thing. I might have to reposition my tripod again. Do we have to detach the Joy-Cons? No. I don't want to do that. Back. Let's just do that later. Oh, it's still going to tell me to detach the Joy-Cons anyway. Alright, fine. attach. So now what I'll do is I'll go ahead and undo the stand. God, that thing is so flimsy. And wow, that does, I am not confident in that sitting there, but okay. So you can use it like this as well. So next, so you can see a little lights on them. I can't read what that says. Can I just like use it handheld again, please? Now it's just telling me to do it like that. Okay. Set your icon and nickname. Alright, can I just like put the Joy-Cons back on, please? Let's see. Huh, actually makes a little sound when you plug them in. Hold on. Unplug them again. It's like the advertising sound. Okay, that's cool. Alright. Sorry, I know it's stupid, but I kind of find that amusing, so. Set my avatar and nickname. Okay. Whoops, wrong button. I'm used to A being the bottom, so. Next. Hold on, back. Can I... What did that say? Transfer data, okay. Not that. You probably can't transfer an old Nintendo account, so. Select an icon, so I have Mario, Peach, Link, Zelda, who else? A few other characters I don't recognize. Animal Crossing, probably a couple others. Let's just go Mario. Or we can be the bitch. Let's be the bitch. Enter my nickname, actually, back. I will select Mario. I don't want to be the bitch. Alright, select my nickname. Let's see, my name is Jack. So, J-A-C-K. Have you ever had your uncle jack off a horse? Yes. Okay, there we go, there is me, apparently. I look like a fat Italian plumber. Oops. I keep pressing B as in back. Alright, done. Okay. But yeah, I meant to press A, I'm used to A being down the bottom. Use a Nintendo account, I think I have a Nintendo account, let me sign in. Because I've played, Super Mario Run on, both iOS and Android, so I think I do have a Nintendo account. System updates, of course. Welcome to 2019, or 2018, or 2017. Welcome to gaming, modern gaming. Okay. Sign in. Can you just let me do the system update now? So a system update cannot be performed during the initial setup of the console. What? Nintendo, are you actually retarded? Like, fine. We'll sign in later then. Skip. Don't want to add another user. Because I need to update the system before I can sign in and do my shit. Alright, I don't want to set parental controls. I'm the only one using it, so. Sub complete. Now you can press the home button. Okay. I wonder if Nintendo are going to have the stupid cutesy music like they do on their home screens in the past. So to play a game, insert your card or download software. Okay. Can I do a system update first? Does it like support like natural scroll? It does. I think as far as I know, this is a plastic screen as well. So like, because they want to like protect the children. Oh no! They gotta do it for the children. Now where's my fucking updates? System update, there we go. Update. Yep. Okay. Update complete. Oh, that was quick. There we go. Alright, so now we're logged in. So what do I just press A to start? Well, it's the same button 3 times. I guess I can set like a password or something. So another update? Oh, for fuck's sake, Nintendo. There we go. How long is this one? It looks like it's going to be quick. Reminds me of the Wii U. I remember when I got my Wii U, I had a system update and I had to download another system update on top of that. Like, they should just take a page out of Microsoft's book and make the... Actually, when it comes to updates, don't take a page out of Microsoft's book, please. Fucking hate Windows 10 for that reason. Although, 1903 seems pretty good these days. When it comes to the update shit. By the time I actually open this flimsy little stand, it's probably gonna be done. Yeah. Yeah, see, I am not confident in that stand holding it. Like I said, they should have done what they did with the Surface Pros. Update complete. Okay. Now, is that everything? We go settings. Flight mode. I'm going to have to go through a lot of this stuff. System update. The system is up to date. Okay, back. Now, is it going to let me sign into like my Nintendo account? Support. Okay. I really want to use this on the big screen. Can I like pair another controller? TV output. Yeah, let me go ahead and plug this into a TV and see if we can use the other controller with it. Okay, so I've managed to pair my little Pro controller here. All I had to do was just plug it in, so it's probably just charging up now. And I've made just about to sign into my Nintendo account, so it looks like I already have one. And it actually looks like it's grabbed my little me character from the Wii U. So yeah, there we go. It says my date of birth is wrong though. So 27/1/96. Yeah, that's older than what I actually am. So by about a year. So let me go link my Nintendo account. There we go. Apologize about the bad angle for the camera here. It's because you're a link to a Nintendo account, you know it's for long features. Friend features. Yeah, yeah, I can have friends. News about games and special offers. Nintendo eShop. Yeah, yeah, I can buy things. And posting screenshots on social networks. Yeah, yeah, I can progress. I can post screenshot of my shitty progression of my fucking game. Alright, of just fails in games probably. Alright, so nickname is me, and icon. Can I choose someone else? Can I just use my, like, actual me? Or not? Oh, I can use my me. Okay. Me from Amiibo, create from likeness, start from scratch. Or do I really have to start from scratch? Can I just use my existing one? Oh well. I mean, that me I designed, like, what, fucking 5 years ago? When I got my Wii U. I mean, to be fair, I don't look that different than I did 5 years ago, even though I'm a fair bit older. I mean, I have a magnificent beard now. I didn't have a magnificent beard 5 years ago. Anyone who disagrees with my beard being magnificent, you're wrong. Friends, I can manage all that crap later. Okay, there we go, theme. Can I use dark mode, please? Like, thank you. Oh, much better. Love dark mode. Yeah, there we go. Alright, I am going to go ahead and pop in a game. So, which one should we play? Let's play Mario Kart, because I've been actually dying to play this since, well, I got rid of my Wii U, actually. I've been wanting to get the Switch version. So, we break that seal there for you with a little screwdriver here. Remember this guy? Yeah. Yeah. Yes, I still use the same old screwdriver to open shit. I've always done that because I'm a fucking redneck, bogan. Anyway, I feel like opening a brand new game, huh? Love that shit. Alright, let's put in the little Switch game card. Wow, those are tiny. They're like SD cards. Now, apparently these have like a... Apparently when these came out, these had like a little taste problem. Like, people, like, they tasted bitter. I'm not gonna go licking mine. I don't really... I feel like I'm a bit more civilized than that. I mean, yeah, I did buy a Switch, and therefore, you know, gonna be dealing with the 360p resolution, but, or whatever the fuck it is, but, I don't care, I wanna play my fucking Mario Kart. So how's this go in? Just pop that open. There we go. Ah, beautiful. There we go. Do I have to install crap? I hope not. Oops. An update is available. I'll be downloading it now. Fine, download. Better not be huge. How big is it? Oh, it looks like it's going quick. Because, I mean, these updates must be spoiled, because my internet's not that fast. Alright, there we go. Looks like update started. Let me go ahead and select the user. And we're going to start the game. Alright. As far as I know, this is a direct port from the Wii U. Except it has the DLC included. Thank you. accusing me. Oh. Whatever, I'll go with that one. Alright. I'm not gonna play multiplayer. I want to later, but let's just do single player for now. Yeah, this looks exactly like the Wii U version. Which I'm not complaining, because this game was really good. The reason I bought the Wii U, so I'll just adjust that so you can have a better view. See if I'm still good at this. The problem with this game, I remember, was the battle mode. It was rubbish. So we're just gonna stick with Grand Prix. Oh yeah, this one has a 200cc. I never actually... Yeah, I know I did play it on the Wii U. Yeah, 200cc was cool. But for now, we'll just stick with 100. 100, because I haven't played this in a couple of years, so I'm probably gonna be a bit rusty. Actually, no, let's do 150. We'll just go... Who should we go with? Remember, I always used to either go with Mario or, just Mario, usually. Because I'm a basic. I never change the kart options either, to be honest. I mean, sometimes I'd go with Rosalina, actually. Or, like... I don't know, I'd change it up every once in a while. Oh, that's Link. Yeah, I never played as Link. If you have Amiibo, I guess you could, like... scan that in if you have a Mario Kart character, I guess. Who should we go with? We'll just go with Mario. Wait, is that, cat suit Mario? It is. Yeah, let's go with him. This is brown! Let's just go standard. Yeah. Alright, what should we race? Some of these are new tracks that are... Yeah, I loved Mute City. That was one of the new ones for the DLC that they added. Let's just do... Oops, wrong button. Let's just do this standard. It's been so long since I played this. Oh, I can't wait to get back into this, man. Can't wait to get back into the online mode. That was fucking rad. I loved it. I was really, it was fucking awesome. Probably wasn't very good, but like... But I didn't get the boost. Alright. That's why you keep the banana behind you like that. Look off. Out of here. Thank you. Forgot to drift. Fuck me. Fuck you. Get out of here. See, even after all these years, I still know the track pretty well. I think the more coins you get, if you get 10 out of 10, the faster you go. As far as I remember, that was the rule with it. Oh, that's new. The Banshee. Oh, just wasted that. Nick of time. Yeah, there we go, I won. Yeah, see, I still got it. I should try 200cc, actually. Quit that. Yeah. Oh, I forgot how much I love this game, dude. Can't wait to play Odyssey as well. That's gonna be rad. A wireless play? Oh, I guess you could play against other Switches. No, that wasn't in the Wii U version. I'll have to get back into the online sometime as well, so... Now, how do you get out of a game? Just go home? Is there a way to quit? Oh, it's a screenshot. Okay, that takes a capture. Can you quit? How do you quit? Is there a way to quit the game? I actually don't know. Options plus, okay. I'm not sure. I'll have to figure this out. I'm not sure. I've actually never used the Switch. I've held one. I've never actually used it though. But anyway, can I quit though? Wait. How do you quit a game? How do I view my album? There's a screenshot, so the one I took accidentally, so let's just delete that, which is X, there it is. I'm getting used to the different button assignments. Alright, back. A and B I can get used to, but like X and Y I'm used to the Xbox controller layout. Since I'm playing that right now. Oh, X is closed software. Okay, there we are. Yeah, close. There we go. And now if I take out a little card. Oh, it's kind of warm and toasty. Yeah, I can feel the fan on the Switch there. So if I take out the little game cartridge, it still shows up in my history. Yeah. There we go. Dear children, do not lick these. They will be disgusting. Okay, anyways, so that looks like that is the Nintendo Switch. As you can see on the clock on there, it says 1:30 in the morning, which is correct because... And I actually start work at 9:30 in the morning later today, so I should probably get to bed, because I'm going to get up at 7. I'm going to get up at 7:30, because I'm going to get a bus at 9 and be at work at 9:30, so... Or train, rather, not bus, sorry. Yeah, so I perhaps better get going, but definitely gonna get into this. If I missed anything in the video, let me know in the comments, and if you have any stuff, if you have any tips or whatever with the Switch, also let me know. Like I said, I will be putting an SD card in there. I have a 32GB one lying around. I'll probably get a bigger, 128 or 256 at some point as well to put in there as well. Anyways, I might even buy more accessories too. Like, I might buy a case for it and even, a screen protector. Because I did kind of notice that even right now, if I take this out, it's actually a little bit scratched already because of the plastic screen, just from taking it out of the dock, so... Yeah, there we go. So that is the Nintendo Switch. So thank you guys very much for watching my video. I'm definitely glad to be back doing this. So I've missed YouTube quite a lot. And like I said, I'm getting my life back together, kind of, trying to sort myself out. If you guys want, a more in-depth video as to what's been going on in my life over the past year, then, let me know and I might make one. Obviously won't go into too much detail, but... Yeah, so let me know what you think, and there will definitely be more videos coming. I've got plenty more videos to come. I've got another one I want to make on the experience of having my iPhone for a year, as well as over a year now. As well as I've got a couple new, I've got a new laptop I want to make a video of, as well as a couple of other things I want to, got a couple other projects I want to work on. So, yeah, definitely gonna be back into this YouTube thing. So, enough rambling. Thank you very much for watching. I will see you in the very short-term future. I promise you that. All right, take care, guys.